Hey you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm doing my 20 week bump date, which is freaking crazy. It's just crazy to say that I'm 20 weeks already. Obviously you guys know that's halfway through my pregnancy. I'm halfway. Like, it's flown by so far, so I don't doubt these next 20 weeks will go by like that. And I'm honestly like kind of getting nervous. Like, it's going by so fast. I need to start planning my baby shower. I need to start deciding on baby names. We need to start buying baby stuff. Like, I mean, obviously, like the big stuff. It's just so crazy that in 20 weeks I'll have my baby boy. Like I had said, I don't want to do these too often because things don't really change. You know, at the beginning, things do change kind of faster. Things change, but it's just not like every single week, you know. I'm going to read you guys what my little app says. How big is my baby? I used to do this with Maricela. And with my last pregnancy updates, I've been forgetting to tell you guys how big he is and everything, so I'm going to start doing that. So 20 weeks today, I have 140 days to go. Your baby is about the size of a banana. Your baby weighs about 10 and a half ounces now. He's also around 6.5 inches long from head to bottom and about 10 inches from head to heel. About the length of a large banana. Alright, so he's the size of a banana, which is pretty big. Bananas are like pretty long. So I definitely have felt him for sure now. Before I thought I felt little flutters here and there, and still to this day he doesn't move a lot. Like, I remember with Maricela, ever since I started feeling her, like, I felt her consistently a lot, and I feel like he's a little bit lazier because I don't, or like just calmer. Maricela's a little bit crazy ever since in my stomach. But I feel like he's a little bit calmer because I don't feel him that often. And I wish I would. Like, I want to start feeling him. But just recently, I have been feeling little, like, flutters. And were, like, to the point where I'm like, oh, okay, like, that's for sure him. Before, I was a little bit like, is that him? Is it not him? So, yeah, that's been really cool. But like I said, it's only been a couple times. I hope this was mine. Maricela and I have all our waters here, and Maricela's tend to have food. So what has changed in the past couple of weeks? So an update on my nausea. I haven't been nauseous. The only time I get nauseous is around nighttime. Only if it's really, really late and I'm super exhausted, like to the point where I need to go to sleep and I'm just doing things. And I have experienced this a couple times, and I know it's like really, it's like when it's getting really late and I'm just super tired, like my body is just exhausted. And usually I try to listen to my body and I'm like, alright, it's time to go to sleep. But just the other night, I was super tired. We were out most of the day and we got home and it was pretty late already. It was the day we took her to like the indoor playground. So this was just a couple days ago, like last weekend. We took her to the indoor playground and she was sweating. She was like, you know, on the playground. So I really wanted to give her a bath even though it was late already. So we got home and I was giving her a bath. And obviously I had to get her ready for bed. I had to get myself ready for bed. And I was really tired. And honestly, I was like really pushing myself. And I ended up throwing up. Because I get so tired that I get nauseous, and that day I was just so extremely exhausted that I ended up throwing my whole day's worth of food. Like, I threw up for a long time. That's the only time I get nauseous, when I'm really, really tired. But like I said, it's important to listen to your body, and yeah, I think I just pushed myself a little too far that day, so that wasn't good. But other than that, I don't really get nauseous. Thank God. Thank you, Lord. You're awesome. Like, that was horrible feeling like that. headaches. I haven't been getting too many headaches, which is awesome because I was getting a lot at the beginning of my pregnancy. I don't have heartburn yet, which I'm also very happy about because with Maricela I did have very bad heartburn, but she did come out very hairy. She has a lot of hair. She has thick hair. So, I don't know. We'll see. Maybe it's coming up soon. Maybe I won't get it. We'll see. So, my appetite is the same. I don't have a huge appetite. Whenever I eat less than what I used to. I don't want to say a little bit because it's not like a tiny bit either. Oh my god, I'm producing so much saliva right now. Is that like related to pregnancy? I don't know what's going on right now. But I do eat less than what I would before. I get full faster, so that makes me like want to have more frequent, smaller meals. So with that being said, I've gained about 2 pounds, which is not a lot for being 20 weeks. With Maricela, I gained a lot. I don't remember exactly how much I gained with her, but I want to say it was about 30 pounds, but I'm not positive. But I did gain a lot with her, so that's why it's weird to me that I haven't been gaining a lot with him. But I can tell that anything I do gain is definitely going to my belly, because the only thing that has been growing is my belly. I don't feel like my face has gotten bigger. My arms, like nothing, my legs, not even like my butt. If anything, my boobs have gotten a tiny bit bigger, which God is probably like, you're welcome, you need it, girl. But nothing else. I haven't gotten swollen, so none of that has happened to me yet. Of course, I'm only 20 weeks. I have a lot of time for that stuff to happen. But yeah, so my weight gain has not been dramatic this time around, but of course we'll see later on when he starts getting bigger and stuff like that. And as long as my doctor says everything's fine, you know, everything's fine, because so far he has been growing the right amount. He's perfect, his heartbeat is perfect, and yeah, he's just amazing. I love him so much already, like I can't wait to meet him. So I do notice that on some days it is a lot harder for me to be standing up or sitting in a certain position. Like sometimes when I'm in class, I have to just like stretch out my back, and then I'll go into a different position, like go forward and side to side, because my back will start to ache or my stomach. Sometimes I'll just be like standing cooking or something, and all of a sudden like my stomach just feels so heavy, like it's weighing me down. So I definitely wanted to look into those pregnancy bands. I don't know if I said that last time. I haven't gotten around to looking at those yet, but I definitely want to look at those because it does get tough sometimes, or usually when we go to church, we get there kind of late, so we don't end up getting a seat. Oh my god, I'm like standing and my back and my stomach is just like so uncomfortable. I can't explain it. Like, I don't know if it's pressure. Like, I just feel like it's like, like aching. So I do get uncomfortable already. And that leads me to my next major point, which is that I don't have insomnia like a lot of pregnant women do, that they can't sleep like just for the heck of it. I wake up so many times during the night because I'm so uncomfortable. And I did try a pregnancy pillow. For those of you that are gonna like recommend that, I did try it. I returned it. I hated it. It didn't help me. I just wake up, I toss and turn, like I'll lay on my left side, on my right side. I even like tend to try to lay like halfway onto my stomach. With Maricela, I remember my doctor had said it was fine to lay on your stomach. As long as you're able to, then it's fine. It's not hurting the baby. So I try that, but all night I'm just like turning from left to right, onto my stomach, onto my back. I can't lay on my back. I'm out of breath. Like, I run out of breath if I'm laying on my back. So it's just very uncomfortable for me. It's tough for me to sleep. I have tried putting like these pillows I try putting this like under my stomach, in between my legs. It works for a little bit and then I just end up kicking it off. So that has been, I want to say, my major problem so far. My most major problem is definitely sleeping at night. It sucks. Also, I wanted to mention that I haven't been waking up in the middle of the night to pee anymore. I don't know if it's because the baby's like higher up now or what, because obviously at the beginning they're lower down, but I haven't been waking up in the middle of the night, which is fun because I dreaded waking up in the middle of the night, going to the bathroom in the dark, like I didn't have my contacts in, I'm blind. But as of right now, guys, I think that's pretty much it. There's not much that has changed. Like I said, my belly is growing and I will show you guys a little belly shot. I'll show you guys on the screen. But my belly is definitely growing. I'm definitely bigger than what I was with Maricela at this amount of weeks. But of course, your second time around, you're always bigger. You grow faster. I feel like my belly shape is way different than with Maricela. So I guess it is true that with a boy, you're a little bit lower down. And with girls, I don't know what they say about girls. That you're round, high up and round, or pointy. I don't know. There's just so many little, like, myths that I don't even know anymore. But yeah, guys, that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoy these little updates. I will continue to do them obviously throughout my pregnancy for you guys to look at and for me to look back at for memories. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.